The day started off at a slow pace as we tried earnestly to wrangle every piece of gear we thought we might possibly need on the mountain.
Oh man, that's bad.
Including many pieces we found we never needed.
What?
Oh, this God. Much butter for the cheesecakes.
We're taking two of them.
Two of them.
Father, I would ask for safety and protection on this expedition as we go up.
You like my bat suit?
You look like a smurf.
We were shooting in the spring, which meant longer daylight hours, but also that the highlight road became unpredictably closed, starting at the dam, making our hike nearly double of what it should have been.
We're up here in highlight. It is roughly 7:10. We've been walking for just over a half hour, and just almost to the end of the reservoir, getting close to where we get into the trees and get hiking up to our climb. So nearly there. We'll get there about dark and set up camp and prepare for the shoot tomorrow, so it looks like it'll be great.
It wasn't great. My bright-eyed optimism lasted till about the end of the road, where the trailhead began. At that point, darkness set in. You can always tell just how bad things get when we stop recording the behind-the-scenes footage of it. That night would prove to be one of the most grueling hikes for any of us. Hauling hundreds if not thousands of pounds of stupid camera equipment, we would arrive at our camp somewhere around 1 to 2 in the morning.
It was nice to wake up fairly refreshed and ready for another day, because last night was a battle. Last night we labored up from the main trail to the side of the falls that we're going to this morning. And we were in the middle of the night, and it was pretty heavy stuff, pretty
good.
Difficult terrain. Too cold. And so, but it was nice to get to camp, have a little fire, have a little hot stuff, soup and whatnot, and that was really good. But yeah, this morning we'll be heading up to film more on the falls, and it should be a good time. It should be a great time. Oh yeah. Got a little oatmeal. Yeah, it's good.
By the way, this is Michael Jones. This man is a boss. 3 days prior, Michael had flown in from sunny Austin, Texas, to jump into the cold, harsh mountain environment of Montana at high elevation.
We're sponsored by
Folk Tab. Thumbs up.
It had been snowing off and on the whole week, and we'd been praying and hoping for good weather conditions in order to film exactly what we needed to get. However, that's not what happened.
Is it the one right next to it, or is it the one?
It'll like go into slow motion. And the ice will be like.
He's got it.
And that looked good. One action on 1, 2, 3.
Whoa.
Things take a lot longer than you think they will out in the mountains of Montana in the wintertime. And as the morning progressed, the snow began to fall heavier and heavier.
What? Are we in shot over there?
I don't know, you have to ask. Okay.
Let's just hope like Jim Joyce doesn't watch any of the behind the scenes footage.
Did you want this one?
Okay.
Dang.
Guys?
Huh?
You're good?
We got all the time in the world.
Here we go!
I'd move.
Yeah.
Yes.
And it was really sketchy ice there. If I would have fell, I would have swung right into the wall.
We were going for the heli shot. We had some windows that were not prime but doable, yeah. and we got the last. We were running out of time, so we tried to get the last effort and. The battery power, I believe, has been affected by the cold. Therefore, we were looking to take off with the standing takeoff, and it was just too low of battery. We would have been just barely lifting off, and it would already been falling. And so we had to call it quits. So,
at this point, all the cameras turned off. And that was 2014. It took nearly a year before we were ready to try again. This time, we hooked up with a contest put on by Snapdragon that required us to shoot the entire thing on a cell phone, which was great because cell phones are really lightweight.
Plant the explosives over there.
With our newly built cable cam, we were able to get some amazing shots.
Yar, head up to the top. You set up some anchor points for the zip line.
I don't always drink lemonade, but when I do, it's Victoria lemonade.
Now on to our third stunt double for Aaron. Robert Hershey got on the rope, rappelled down, and started to climb up the sheer ice, allowing us to capture this moment.
Let's get to painting.
What does Bob Ross always say? I forget.
Just a happy little tree over here. No mistakes, just happy accidents.
In the warehouse of Mattress Mill, we set up our canvas and lights and got to work.
Just getting prepared. It's a real mental, painting has a mental toll on a person if you're not ready. If you're not prepared.
Combining the lessons learned from the 2014 expedition, a little ingenuity, a lot of hard work, and a whole lot of laughs, we were finally able to realize this vision, years in the making, winning the contest.